Petoskey Northman basketball on WJML is brought to you tonight by your local Petoskey UPS store, your certified packaging expert, located in the Mitchell Street Plaza near Radio Shack. Silver Dollar Business Solutions, increase your business's bottom line with value-added electronic payment services. Northern Michigan Artist Market, with art in all media by over 90 local Northern Michigan artists from Traverse City to the top of the Upper Peninsula. At 445 East Mitchell Street, next to the old library in Petoskey's historic Gaslight District. And special thanks to WJML Radio, News Talk Sports, 1110 and 1210, and worldwide on WJML.com. Hello, everybody. This is Marty Scott. We are at Gaylord High School for tonight's opening game of the Big North Conference season. I've got the JV just finished their game. They came back very nicely in the second half. They were down by a lot to not very many in the first half of the game. Final score 41-11 as the Gaylord team did pretty well with it. JV's coming along. They got some work to do, but they got a lot of time to work on it. We've got Jason Bassett here handling all the switches and dials and all that. And a special new member of the team, Caitlin Crittenton. You probably remember her from all, you probably know her better than you know me. We walked into the gym tonight and it's like people are mobbing her, all her former teammates and everybody. Caitlin was one of the stars of the team for the last several years. She's now a student at North Central Michigan College. And most importantly, right now she's here with us doing color on our broadcast all season long. So, Caitlin, welcome to the team. Thanks very much for being here.
Thank you, Marty. It's great to be back and be within the program.
Okay, well, we're getting ready to get started tonight. The teams are coming out on the court. We've got the pretty full bleachers back there behind us. And it's pretty exciting to be getting the season started. Now, you've played with a lot of these Northland players, and ones that you haven't exactly played with, you know most of them that were on the JV the year before. And I saw you at the game, against Marquette. So you've actually had a chance to see them play this year. Just what do you think of the new Northland team?
I was surprised how well they came out this year compared to last year. Last year we definitely struggled with turnovers and meeting our passes, and this year they did really well with help defense, which really stood out to me. You know, with someone got around their player, the next person was there. Having their hands up to steal the ball was definitely great to see. They just struggle with the full court pressure. They don't have someone to really take the ball up the court, and they're not the best at meeting their passes yet, but hopefully they looked at that over this past week in practice and really can improve on that.
Well, you missed the game against St. Ignace. That was the disaster on full court pressure. St. Ignace had them all over the place. They couldn't get the ball out of their own end, and when they brought it up the court, they were getting double teamed all the time. They never saw it coming. They didn't pass away from it. But the game you saw, I thought, you know, they say that the biggest improvement that you make in a season is between the first game and the second game, when you get those initial things out of the way. And they certainly were a lot better against Marquette.
Yeah, I bet they were. It's totally, you know, opening game is a big night and your nerves are going and you never know what is going to come out. You've been working all pregame trying to get what you want, and I bet the first game and second game was a big improvement. They really just have to work on the opposite person flashing and keep moving the ball up the court and utilize, you know, we have a lot of tall girls on the team like Megan Tompkins and Kelsey Anson. We're really timid at dribbling the ball when we have, I feel, more than capable of a couple girls dribbling up the court or whatever it takes.
Well, Melissa Van Wert does a good job of that. You know,
yes.
She really does a good job bringing the ball up.
And she's really stepped up this past year, I've noticed, taking the ball to the hoop, which last year she did, you know, towards the end of the season and a little bit towards the beginning. But this year, and it really amazed me how well she improved in that.
Well, it's a lot more fun to talk about the second half of your season last year than it is to talk about that first half. And I don't want to bring back any bad memories, but one of the people who, is that a signal for me there, Jason? All right, sounds like we're going to take a short break, and we'll be right back to continue this discussion on WJML News Talk Sports 1110 and 1210 and worldwide on WJML.com.
Join the crowds at Gobblers of Gaylord and try their complete turkey dinners, just like Grandma used to make, with all the fixings. Famous throughout all of northern Michigan. And yes, Gobblers offers more than just turkey. Enjoy walleye, lake perch, cod, slow-roasted prime rib every day, and homemade soups and sandwiches. Treat yourself to Barb's tasty carrot cake, too. Check out Gobblers' $3.79 breakfast special, the $5.99 lunch special, and the $6.99 daily dinner specials. All at Gobblers of Gaylord and just south of Gobblers in Waters. Visit the all-new Bros Bistro just off of I-75. Bros Bistro is healthy gourmet dining at moderate prices. Friday night, pan-fried perch and walleye, urban-crusted prime rib on Saturday nights, and Sundays, it's a complete chicken dinner. Bros Bistro is also serving up tasty baby back ribs, so moist and tender, and smoked right out back. Stop in and check out Bros Bistro just off I-75 at exit 270 in Waters.
Hydration isn't something athletes do just during a practice or game. Good hydration takes place before practices and games as well. You can learn more about good hydration and heat acclimation by visiting the MHSAA website, clicking on Education, and checking out the various resources, including a free online course offered by the National Federation. A message from the Michigan High School Athletic Association, promoting the value and values of educational athletics.
Bob, what are you doing out there with that rifle and dynamite?
I hated that old credit card machine so much that after Silver Dollar Business Solutions came by, this'll be fun.
No, that's dangerous.
Oh, we don't need that old thing anymore. Silver Dollar Business Solutions got me a better system and lowered my rates. My customers are happy with quicker checkout, and we're keeping more of our hard-earned revenue.
Well, it sounds like you've really thought through the business part, but that pile of dynamite has me worried.
Oh, it'll be great.
If you own or manage a business and hate your credit card processor, Silver Dollar Business Solutions can help. Whether you need to lower your costs on your current equipment or replace your processing system, Silver Dollar Business Solutions is here for you. You will be so happy you'll want to celebrate, but please don't do anything dangerous.
I guess the dynamite wasn't such a good idea.
2-3-1-7-5-8-2-8-5-1 Silver Dollar brings value to you.
All right, we're back here at Gaylord High School getting ready for the start of the Big North Conference season. This may be the start of the season, but the Northmen have played a couple of games already. They had the Petoskey Invitational last week against St. Ignace, and then the Consolation game against Marquette. They lost the St. Ignace game 53-38, and then turned around and beat Marquette 38-31. Fell a little behind in the beginning of that game, but came up. Got out. They were ahead at the beginning of that game, 11-4, quite ahead at halftime. And then Marquette kind of came back in the second half and the third quarter in particular. But it was a good game. Megan Tompkins named to the all-tournament team. She had 11 points and 13 rebounds in that game. Doing a good job of moving her feet and getting work done inside.
Yes, she's definitely finding where she wants to be positioned down low and getting a body on someone and squaring up to that basket and shooting. She has definitely developed a lot more moves underneath the basket.
And she was showing off those volleyball skills with her five blocks. There were some really great ones where people thought they had a shot and they take it, and then all of a sudden she was up in the air knocking that ball away. It was
not only her blocks, but there's a couple of putbacks she had as a set in the game too.
Yep. Kelsey Ants, as always, major contribution as well. She got 10 points, 10 rebounds, doing a good job on the defensive end as well, and four assists. The third high scorer in the game was Alyssa Van Worden, who was right up there with 9 points and five rebounds. The whole team had 19 turnovers, which sounds like a lot to me. They did a better job against the press, but that shows that they still have some work to do in controlling the ball. And they got 20. On the other hand, they got 22 points in the paint, which to me that's a pretty good indication of being able to get the ball inside and penetrating and getting in it's where the good shots are.
Yes, it's great that they are utilizing their height. Marquette was a rather small team this year, so it's good that they're using Megan and Kelsey and Alyssa down there. And
yep. They were 41% shooting from the floor, which is okay, but
that's pretty good. It's solid, you know. They definitely have a little bit room for improvement, but that's pretty good for them.
And it was a win against a good team, you know, no question about that. All right, before we run out of time, let's talk a couple of minutes about the Gaylord Blue Devils. They also lost to St. Ignace in the only game that they played this year. They played them right before we had a chance to. They lost 69-51, so it was a pretty close game, and they actually were ahead at halftime, 38-30. Then St. Ignace, you know, in what they call the character quarter, the third quarter, where you come out and show what you can really do, they started out the third quarter with a 7-0 run, and Edwards really broke the game open. She had a high game high of 22, but the important thing about her play is what happened to her later on in the game.
And I actually got to talk to her about it. I just talked to her outside in the hallway. Edwards broke her arm, and she will be out till after break. So thankfully, it's not that bad of a break where she's going to be out the whole season. The team is definitely looking at her, but also talking to Coach Hamilla. He's hoping that the other girls take advantage of this timeout so they learn how to step it up and they can see more people on the court scoring. Paulina and Hamilla have been on the team for 3 or 4 years, so he's looking at them to take the lead, and they're going to utilize their quickness right now and trying to push the ball up and down the court, try beating us with their speed.
Well, and Mackenzie Edwards is the dominating scorer on this team, has been for a couple of years, and that means that in the last couple of years, she got to play a lot of basketball against you.
Yes.
Because you usually drew that assignment playing against the top scorer. She must have been happier to see you tonight than she was this time last year.
It was definitely probably better for her to see me tonight. I'm glad we ended. I saw her on good terms, though. So.
Yeah. Now they have a lot of juniors on their team as well, and maybe we'll get a chance to talk about them a little bit. But the game's going to be starting pretty soon. We only have about 4 minutes to go before the opening festivities, so we'll take a short break here on WJML News Talk Sports 1110 and 1210, and worldwide on WJML.com.
This holiday season, give the gift that gives to others. Shop from home, save on gas, avoid the crowds, and most importantly, support your local charitable organizations to serve others who need help right here in Northern Michigan. It's the WJML Alternative Gift Mall, online at northernmichiganmall.com, and click on Alternative Gifts. You can donate to local organizations in someone's honor and receive gift cards describing each gift. Choose from charities such as the Manna Food Project, the Community Free Clinic, the Harbor Springs Food Pantry, Great Start Preschool, the Northwest Michigan Community Action Agency, the Nehemiah Project, Women's Resource Center, and Habitat for Humanity. 100% of all donations go directly to the organizations that you choose. Celebrate the spirit of the season. Support your community with gifts from the WJML Alternative Gift Mall, online at northernmichiganmall.com.
They officiate because they love the game that gave so much to them, and they want to give back to it. They officiate because they believe that the mission of high school sports is to help educate kids. They'd like you to join their ranks, so why don't you? To become a registered high school game official, call or click the Michigan High School Athletic Association. A message from the MHSAA, promoting the value and values of educational athletics.
This year, the gift I'm getting is more time, and I'm getting it from that happy, jolly guy, Bob at the UPS store. Bob is a certified packing expert. He packs up my gifts, ships them out, and gets me in and out quickly. He even has extended holiday and weekend hours. Oh, he says that he gets it done with logistics. I think he has elves and a sleigh.
To find the location of the UPS store near you, visit theupsstore.com. Services, prices, and hours vary by location. See center for details.
Your local Petoskey UPS store is your certified packing expert, located in the Mitchell Street Plaza near Radio Shack. Mention you heard this ad and you'll get a 10% discount on in-store custom packaging.
get underway here. There's about a minute and a half left before the starting festivities. It was nice to hear from the UPS store there, where they're going to be back with us at halftime, sponsoring the UPS Store of Petoskey halftime show, and we're looking forward to that. We may have a special guest down here at halftime, too, but we won't promise anybody until they show up, you know, so we'll see what happens. But, Kaylin, we just have a couple of seconds here before we get started. What are you looking forward to at the beginning of this game that's really going to give you an indication of how things are going to go?
Well, it's really going to see how Petoskey sets the tempo. Gaylord's team's just going to want to push up down in court and see if, you know, if they allow that to happen, or are they going to try slowing them down, making sure someone's back on defense and covering the ball and utilizing when we can push up the ball up the court, and just really working on looking at backside and our post tonight.
Okay, and as you say, it looks, looking over these teams and looking down the roster, like we do have a pretty significant height advantage inside, as we will against most teams that we play this year. So it'll be interesting to see how that develops as well. And now we get the buzzer, so the court announcer here is going to start giving us all those important announcements. And before that, we'll get the national anthem. So we'll take a break and listen to the national anthem right along with you. National anthem. While I was looking at the flag, I was noticing the pennants on the wall here, and nice Petoskey Northman pennant right in the middle. But they need to get themselves an Ogma Heights pennant now that they're in the conference. We've got to get that up there and get started. Right now, we're getting the starting lineups announced. So, Kaylin, you've got the starting lineups here for both teams.
Yes,
go right ahead.
So, starting lineup for Petoskey Northman is Megan Tompkins. She's a 6'3 senior. Liz Frazier, a 5'6 senior. Kelsey Ant, a 5'10 senior. Katie Lewis, a 5'3 junior. And Alyssa Van Warden, a 5'9 senior. For Gaylord Blue Devils, we have Chelsea Fox, a senior. Madison Hamilla, a senior. Alex Simmons, who also is a senior, and Sarah Paulina, a senior, and Stephanie Buttrix, a senior.
All right, and the Gaylord Blue Devils, blue and gold, the mostly white uniforms today, being the home team, Petoskey Northman in their usual road blue. I want to ask you about this. The Northmen are doing their usual, I call it star pattern there in the free throw circle. What did that start? Is there a history to that?
I don't know what the history. I just remember doing it ever since I was a freshman on the team. Really, the captains talk and, you know, say what they want to capitalize on the court tonight. If it's, you know, making sure your help defense or we're getting up and down the court, boxing out, whatever they feel the need to say. And if someone else wants to speak up, it's more than welcome. You don't have much time, but to just really get your mindset.
Right, get everybody focused on the game and a little inspirational message
just
in there.
Just a little bit.
Yeah, okay, and get a chance for the captains to get those messages out there in a way that the coach really can't. Sometimes it's better to get that from your teammates, you know, last minute going on the field. Team's getting their last minute instructions from the coaches right now, and we're going to be off to a start right away. The team's getting into the tip-off circle, and all we need now is the officials and the basketball, and we'll be all set to start. Out there is Megan Tompkins for the Northmen, and across the circle is Chelsea Fox for the Blue Devils. Surprisingly enough, Megan Tompkins gets the tip-off, and Kelsey Ants over on the right-hand side dribbles all the way down, shoots it up from the baseline, rebound off the rim, comes down, and it's tied up between Ants and Fox. That arrow giving the ball at the first tie-up to the Blue Devils, and they start the ball off from there into the court. Across mid-court, it is Buttrick over on the right-hand side, passes it off. Tied up in the corner, they pass it into the middle and down on the floor, and Kelsey Ants comes up with the ball. Up in front to Alyssa Van Worden, back to Kelsey Ants, and over on the side to Katie Lewis. Deep into Tompkins, back to Ants across the key. Ants turns around, gets on the baseline, and tries to pass it across to Megan, but she wasn't expected to pass it out of bounds to the Blue Devils.
Right now the Blue Devils are playing a 2-3 zone. Petoskey, Northman, we kind of want to work the balls both sides of the court to make sure we're getting them tired.
All right, Northman now on defense. No score, 7-11 now, just underway at the beginning of the first quarter. It's Shelby Kuhn with the ball out on the top for the Blue Devils. Now they get into the baseline, back outside on the left, back out on top. And out on top, it's Sarah Polena, one of the senior stars. Pass goes out of bounds, knocked out of bounds by the Northman, and it's going to be Alexandra Simmons on the sideline, throwing the ball in. Out on top to Polena. Polena down the left-hand side. She double-teamed, throws over to the other side to Buttrick, and Buttrick backs it up and sets the offense back up again. Megan Tompkins out on her. Over to the left-hand side now. That's Polena. Polena brings it back out on top as the Petoskey defense keeping them out of the inside. And just as I say that, they drive down but don't really get by Megan Tompkins. Put it up, and she gets Tompkins gets a rebound. And now Van Worden brings the ball all the way down the lane, puts a shot up, and it's out of bounds. And looks like they call a foul on that.
No, they called it out on Blue Devils.
All right, so the Northman bringing the ball in, and that's Lewis who brings it back out on top to Tompkins. As soon as she gets the ball, there is contact out there, and the ball's going to be back out of bounds. How were they calling this on?
It's a jump ball right now.
Okay. Jump ball, so this time it's the Northman's turn on the jump ball, and Lewis again bringing it in from under the basket. And now they stop. And it was
they called an offensive foul on Megan Tompkins in the corner. I guess she just pushed off someone. I didn't see it.
While they were setting up for the play, because the ball was still out of bounds when they called it. First foul on anybody, obviously Megan's first, and now the Blue Devils with the ball. At the top of the key, there is Simmons out there at the top trying to get the ball in. As they shoot, it's knocked away by Van Worten. And back outside to the Blue Devils. They bring it down on the left-hand side. Can't get in the lane. Shot is rebounded by Tompkins. But as she tries to bring it down, it's batted away from her. A sprawl on the floor as everybody's going for the ball. And they call it a jump this time. That's going to the Blue Devils.
You can really tell that this game is already, the intensity in everyone right now playing is getting pretty high. And it's just going to increase.
And the entry pass for the Blue Devils is intercepted by Van Worden, And they're quickly up to the forecourt over to Lewis on the far side. Lewis looking around for somebody. Passes it all the way over the top to Ants. And Ants looks in, finds Tompkins in the middle. She passes it over to the baseline, and it's back out on top. Right-hand corner now as Kelsey gets open. And they it's pretty close to the line, but they call it a two. So Northam get the first blood in this game, 2-0 with 5:27 remaining in the first quarter. Over on the right-hand side now, Buttrick gets the ball to throw it across the key to the baseline, but it's over the head of Simmons and out of bounds. Kelsey Ants with the ball, bringing it in for the Northmen. Van Worden to Lewis, still in the backcourt. So not much motion back there, but they pass the ball up in the forecourt. It's Ants over on the right-hand side, over to Lewis all across the key on the other side. She passes it back to Fraser, who puts it up and in, and that was a three. Five altogether for the Northmen with 5 minutes remaining in the first quarter, 5-0.
That was a great going in and reversing the ball.
Chelsea Fox takes it in, but knocked away, and Kelsey Ants has it. Her pass gets away, and it's recovered by the Blue Devils. Polina bringing the ball up the court now to Buttrick. Back out on top to Polina. She's looking over the offense, trying to find somebody open. No movement in there by the Blue Devils. And they finally pass it around to the left-hand side to Simmons. She dribbles across to the middle. There's some movement inside, but they're not able to get any penetration, so they shoot the three from the top of the key, and the rebound comes to Van Worden. She gets all the way down into the lane, but passes it off to Fraser. Fraser's hit as she tries to pass it into the lane, I think by Madison Hamilla. Well, they call that on Polina, and that's her first foul. It's going to get the ball out of bounds. Not sure.
Right now we have a timeout, it looks like. Petoskey right now really needs to just start dribbling it in and reversing the ball. They're running that 2-3 zone, so you know, just passing around the outside is not going to do much. By dribbling in, it's going to get them out of their rhythm, and hopefully we can get someone out on the open or someone backside to pop up.
Yeah, so far they seem to be passing over the zone, trying to go from one side to the other, which is a bad tactic, but it's not getting them.
Yes, they need to penetrate them so they can really break their system and get them off their feet.
Now, that last time down, they sort of did that. They got that pass inside to Megan, but then she turned right around and threw it to the perimeter on the side. So maybe, you know, she felt that she didn't have a shot if she was being covered or whatever. But now back to live action as the play comes inbounds to Fraser on the top over to Lewis on the left-hand side. Lewis looks into the middle, keeps the ball, drives towards the lane, backs it out, throws to Van Worden in the middle. She turns around, passes it back out to Fraser. Kelsey Ass comes down the lane, falls, or is tripped, rather, as she gets in the lane. And no call. Something happened in there, but
called it as a travel on her, but questionable.
Ball out of bounds, and now the Blue Devils bring it up court. Over on the right-hand side, pretty close to the baseline is Fox. She gets it into the middle as they finally get a shot in the middle, and they score 2 points now for the Blue Devils. I didn't see who got that.
I think it was Hamilla, but I'm not positive.
All right, so 5-2 Northman with 3:34 remaining in the first quarter. Northman now across the timeline to Van Worden on the right-hand side, back across to Lewis on the left. Lewis looking over the offense. Nobody, no movement at all going on there. So Lewis is kind of hanging out there to dry, waiting for somebody to give it to. Van Worden pops out on the left, and she gets the ball back to Fraser out on top. Ants on the right side, all across the other side to Van Worden, dribbles into the lane and runs in to Stephanie Buttrick, big girl for the Blue Devils there. And foul is called on Buttrick, her first foul, team second. Hannah Schulten coming into the game, and who else?
Amanda Stinger.
Oh, we got one of those home uniform visitor uniform number things, right?
So
Stinger's 24.
I know them by their faces.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, but, so I didn't have that number on the card. So, but thank you very much.
You're welcome.
We got that cover now. All right. Anyway, 5-2 with 3 minutes remaining. Gaylord with the ball, gets it up to the baseline. They go under the basket, but can't do anything with it. Taken away by the Northmen, and then batted away from the Northmen. And it's going to be out of bounds possession. Petoskey. Schulten bringing the ball in from the baseline. Play's getting a little ragged now, Caitlin, I think.
Just a little bit, you know. It's getting a little elbows here and there, but.
Okay. Van Worden with the ball over to Fraser as they get it finally across the timeline. Van Worden coming along on the right-hand side. Brings it back out to the top of the key. She looks into the offense. Now they're cycling around in there, so she drives in, but stops, passes it over to the right-hand side to Schulten. Schulten out there where she could take a three, passes it up, passes to Tompkins, and back out to Schulten, back out across on top of that. Crossing pass broken up, and a layup there for Madison Hamilla, and that brings them within one, 5-4, with 2:11 remaining in the first half. Into the forecourt now, Schulten on the right-hand side. Passes it in the middle to Van Worden. She drives the lane, hits the rim. Tompkins underneath, gets the rebound, has no room, passes it out to whatever. When she passes it out, it's knocked away, and the Blue Devils get it. Gaylord with the ball in their forecourt now, and a traveling called, and Northman get the ball out of bounds.
Petoskey really needs to just slow it down right now. They're pressing, and we need to be looking backside. We have people flashing, but they're covering that flash.
What do you mean they're covering the flash?
The Gaylord team is covering the person that's flashing in the middle. So the Blue Devils right now are running a 1-3-1.
And they intercept, they pass across the timeline, they bring it back down to the forecourt. They're only trailing by one, but Megan Tompkins gets the rebound, and Van Worden brings the ball down the right-hand side. She brings it in the middle, stops and catches it, turns around, finds Schulten over on the left-hand side. Hannah looking around, gets cross-court to Van Worden down in the right-hand corner, but taken away. A lot of inaccurate passing now. Quickly up the court is Simmons, and her shot off the rim. Northman with the ball now with just a minute remaining in the first quarter, leading only by one, 5-4. Liz Fraser on the top, passing it over to the left-hand side, now in to Stinger, and then across court, and down to the baseline. They try to get it inside to Stinger, but ball taken away, and foul called on Ants. Her first
Amanda Stinger.
Her called on Stinger. Okay, I thought they signaled Kelsey, but it's good we don't want to see Kelsey getting into foul trouble at this point.
Not at this point.
No. And so that's the third foul for the Northmen. 45 seconds remaining now, and the Blue Devils bring the ball out under their own basket. Get it up to midcourt, and that's Polena with the ball. Passing it over to her right to Hintz. Back out on top to Fox. Over on the right-hand side to Simmons. Get the ball into the baseline, put it up. The Gaylord player's down on the floor. Kelsey helps her up. Seen that before. Sometimes she helps somebody up and lets them fall back down again.
But yeah.
She's tough. But foul called on, that is on Stinger.
And it's her second.
And at the line, shooting, it puts that in, and that is, Simmons. So that ties up the game with about half a minute remaining here in quarter number one. She's got another shot, so Gaylord has a chance to take the lead right here, and they do. Northman with the ball with half a minute remaining, and they're bringing it pretty slowly out of the zone. Kelsey Ann standing in the midcourt with her hands up, but they choose to throw it over the other way. Gets to Gaylord, but then taken back quickly by the Northman. Van Worden up on the right-hand side, drives into traffic. On the baseline now is Stinger. Puts a shot up, and it goes in right at the buzzer. Well, just before the buzzer, Gaylord gets a shot from midcourt at the buzzer. That was short. So where you get to the end of the first quarter with the Northmen ahead by one thin point, 7-6. And we'll be right back with the second quarter in just a minute on WJML News Talk Sports 1110 and 1210 and worldwide on WJML.com. Championship.
Join the crowds at Gobblers of Gaylord and try their complete turkey dinners, just like Grandma used to make with all the fixings. Famous throughout all of northern Michigan. And yes, Gobblers offers more than just turkey. Enjoy walleye, lake perch, cod, slow-roasted prime rib every day, and homemade soups and sandwiches. Treat yourself to Barb's tasty carrot cake, too. Check out Gobblers' $3.79 breakfast special, the $5.99 lunch special, and the $6.99 daily dinner specials. All at Gobblers of Gaylord and just south of Gobblers in Waters. Visit the all-new Bros Bistro just off of I-75. Bros Bistro is healthy gourmet dining at moderate prices. Friday night, pan-fried perch and walleye. Urban-crusted prime rib on Saturday nights. And Sundays, it's a complete chicken dinner. Bros Bistro is also serving up tasty baby back ribs. So moist and tender and smoked right out back. Stop in and check out Bros Bistro just off I-75 at exit 270 in Waters.
We're back live here as we start action in the second quarter. Northman with the ball and passing it over to the right-hand side to Lewis. Lewis back to Van Worden and back out on top to Ann. She puts a shot up from the free throw line, goes off the bracket, and falls down to Gaylord, who gets the ball out of bounds. Just underway in the second quarter. Gaylord bringing the ball up court. They are trailing to the Northman by 1-7-6. Now they get the ball up on the right-hand side, back out on top to Simmons. Simmons over to the left-hand side to Polena. Polena dribbles it back out on top. She's being guarded by Lewis. Back out on top, and this one, a three-pointer from the top, goes up and over. Rebounded by the Blue Devils. They bring it back out on top to Hamilla. Hamilla over to the right-hand side to Polena. Polena looking for an opening. Petoskey doing a pretty good job of jamming up the middle here. Tries to drive down the middle, but Van Worden's right there to cut it off. So they try a three-point shot from the outside. It misses and goes out of bounds. So what about the absence of Mackenzie Edwards? Are we seeing that have an effect here?
I definitely could see we're having an effect. I'm kind of happy right now that she's not playing because we're not playing so well either. So if they had her on the court, definitely helped their team out a lot
more.
Yeah,
if they had that offensive weapon. All right, Lisa Van Worden steps in the middle and intercepts a pass, brings it up the floor for the Northman over the right-hand side to Weaver. Weaver down into the corner to Kelsey Ants. Ants turns around, finds Weaver back out on the outside. And believe that's...
We got a five-second call.
Okay. So turns the ball over to Gaylord. They're within one. Northman leading 7-6 as they bring the ball back out. Over on the right-hand side, gets across the timeline. That's Polena over to the left-hand side to Hintz. Back out on top to Polena. And now Simmons tries to break around the key to the right-hand side. Stops. Ants is in her face, so she backs up and pass it out. They shoot it into the middle, but right there is Abby Blanchard, who just came into the game, and she intercepts the pass. They call foul on Ryder, Jocelyn Ryder for Blue Devils. One of those classic, you miss the play, then you try to catch up by reaching in,
yeah.
And she got Buttrick on the arm. Northman with the ball now leading 7-6, 6:06 remaining second quarter. Over the right-hand side to Fraser. Over to the left now to Ant, shooting a three from the outside, puts it in. Her first three of the game, 10-6 now Northman. Well, that's one way to get
those
shots.
Yeah, they're looking now from the outside because they're guarding that post in the inside with two to three people down there.
Driving through the lane, Gaylord, but not much room in there. Get the ball back outside. It's taken away by Kelsey Ants. She gets the ball halfway up the court. She's looking around, decides to stop and pop from the top of the key. She does. Off the rim and out of bounds off one of the Blue Devils. Yeah, it's good to see Kelsey making that three-point shot. You know, that may help loosen up things on the inside.
Sure.
Baseline pass intercepted by the Blue Devils. And we have Sarah Polena getting the ball quickly up to Simmons on the left-hand side. Back out on top to Polena. Underneath, they get inside. That's Hamilla, but runs right into traffic. And I think
Abby Blanchard got her arm in there. So
So foul called on Blanchard. That's her first. Team's fifth. And at the line, we have Hamilla. And she puts it in. 10-7 right now. Northern leading by three. So I take all those easy opportunities to do the math when it's real simple.
Okay. Gaylord's always been known for having a great free throw shooting team, which, you know, those are the points that count coming down to the end of a game.
Yeah, well, that one misses off the bracket. Ants looks up court, which we're beginning to, hopefully we'll see a little more of this season. But the ball gets to Fraser, who can't do anything with it, and it's turned over to the Blue Devils. They bring the ball down the court and fumble it out of bounds, so Kelsey Ants is going to bring it in from the baseline. And now it's Fraser with the ball, looking for a little help back there. This is not much of a press, but they do have people up the court there, and they're bothering them a little bit. Ball goes to Kelsey, who quickly finds Larson, gets the ball into the forecourt.
She passes it to Blanchard, and Blanchard is now taking some free throws.
So, having committed a foul herself, she gets a chance to stand at the free throw line. And Blanchard there for her first shot. Around the inside of the rim and out, but she's got another opportunity coming. We've got 4:50 remaining in the first half. Northman leading by three. Blanchard at the line. And that one, nothing but net. So Northman take a four-point lead, 11-7. And the Blue Devils get the ball out of bounds.
Right now, Petoskey really wants to focus on good ball pressure and getting up in their passing lane so they won't be able to get that easy pass.
Ball over to the left-hand side to Buttrick. She's got it back out on top. No lanes available on the inside right now. Hintz tries cutting through. Nothing happens. Pass over across the top to Fox. Over in the corner is the only shot they can get, and that goes over the top of the net. Driving now down into the lane as they get inside is Chelsea Fox, and her shot counts. So 11-9 now, Northman with 4:17 remaining in the first half. Ants in the forecourt finds Tompkins all by herself under the basket. Puts it up. That's really the first really nice play to the inside so far this game.
So far, we really need to work on sticking to our box outs and going to the ball after our box out.
Ball in the hands of the Blue Devils in forecourt now over on the right-hand side down in the corner. They get it back out on top to Hamilla. Hamilla tries to pass it through, but there's nobody there to pick it up. It's out of bounds to the Northman. Good job of defense on that series there by the Northman. Ball comes into Van Worden and over to Fraser on the far side, on the left-hand side. Into Ants in the middle. Ants got an open lane to the basket, takes it, and puts the layup. It came in from the top of the key and got all the way to the hoop.
We keep doing this, then they'll end up not pressing us, which would be definitely in our favor, but so far we got to keep proving to them that we can handle their pressure.
Well, Ants got the shot from outside and made that, and when she got the ball on the outside, the next time they opened up the lane for her, and she just went right down and put the layup in.
It's great that we're showing that we're a threat from the inside, but also the outside, too. You know, we've had Liz Frazier score a three. We had Kelsey Ann score a three. We had Natalie Weaver from the outside. So they're going to start playing up on us, which should open up Tompkins down low or Kelsey or whoever's down in that post position.
Well, the Gaylord coach, Frank Hamilla, who's been doing this for a while, obviously felt it was time to talk about it and stop things and straighten that problem out. And get a team on the sidelines, and they come back in. Let's see if they listen to him. Here comes the ball inbounds over to Hamilla as she brings it up the middle and across the timeline and tries to pass it inside on the right-hand side, but it's knocked out of bounds. And Gaylord with the ball, bringing it in from the far side. That's Fox into Buttrick, and ball still way out on top. It's now Polina with the ball. She dribbles over to the left-hand side. They cannot get inside. Right now it is Buttrick with the ball on the left-hand side. She gives it up, still around the perimeter. And as Gooding changes her mind about throwing the ball to the right-hand side, she's called for a travel. 3:13 remaining in the first half. Northman leading 15-9. and throws the ball in for the Northmen. That's Fraser with it in the backcourt, passes it up to Van Worden, back to Ants in the middle. Ants throws it, but it's blocked by Buttrick, I thought, off her feet.
It looked like it was either off her foot or her leg, but they would have called a kick if it was off her foot. So
I guess it must not have been off her foot, or they would have called it.
Yeah.
Ants with the ball out of bounds. Now she brings it in. Van Worden with it on the still short of the timeline. They get it to Fraser. Still having a little trouble getting across the midline, but now they get it to Van Worden on the left. Back outside, a three shot by Fraser. That's off the front of the rim, and it comes down to Gaylord. 2:46 remaining. Gaylord out of the top of the key for a three. That one's off the bracket and rebounded by Van Worden. So Gaylord's still having trouble getting inside. They try to go from the outside, but it didn't work. Ants passes it to Van Worden at the top of the key. Van Worden off the bracket as well. Tompkins gets a rebound inside and passes it out to Fraser. Ants from the left-hand side off the rim, and they called something.
It hit the court on top of the basket, so they called it like an out-of-bounds play.
There you go. And Gaylord now, as a result, brings the ball in with 2:18 remaining in the first half. They're trailing the Northmen by 6, 15-9. Out on top there, it is Sarah Polena. She is nicely guarded, closely guarded by Fraser over there. They go down on the court and tie it up. And it's going to be Blue Devils' ball on the fickle finger there, pointing over towards the Blue Devils. But that uses up one of those, and now it's the Northmen's turn when they get the ball out again. And it stopped the possession in the drive. Ball's in now underneath. Oh, they got inside. They got to the baseline. That was Kuhn who had a shot, but she missed the layup. Van Worden now over to the left-hand side to Skolten. Back out on the top, and that's a three by Van Worden. So another shot from the outside going in. 18-9 as the Northmen have doubled the Blue Devils here with a minute 41 remaining in the first half. Ball on the right-hand side, that's Polena. She does get inside, but getting inside when Tompkins is there is not enough. And as she goes up to shoot,
Alyssa Van Worden was the one that blocked that one. Yeah.
Well, Van Worden was in front of her, and Tompkins was next to her. She wasn't going to have much of an opportunity no matter what happened. The ball goes out of bounds, and Gaylord brings it back in. They have Buttrick over on the left-hand side. It's out at the top. They're tied up out there. Northman contesting the ball everywhere. That was Ants. Now it's back out on top. Gaylord with the ball on the right-hand side. Polena with it. Drew brings it back to the timeline. Finds Fox inside. They pass it over to the left, and then further out to the left, try to curl and drive in again, but it doesn't work. Back out on top to Simmons. She shoots from the free throw line. Everybody, over everybody, hits the bottom of the basket, and then rebounded by the Blue Devils and eventually the Northmen. They get the ball up to the right-hand side. Tompkins at the top of the key. She tries to drive in. A little tough for a big person to do that. They stopped her. Ball now down for the Northmen end, and Tompkins does something a little more natural for her, which is jumping up and knocking the ball out. A couple people down on the floor as a result of that, including who is that? Looks like Simmons stands up, rubbing her head and her knees. She's going to the free throw line. Foul called on Tompkins. That was her second. And that free throw is in. And that brings the score to 18-10. Blanchard coming in, and Megan Tompkins getting a break here. They'll take her out with 50 seconds remaining in the first half, give her a nice break, and get those two fouls out of the game.
You can tell the girls are starting to get a little bit more tired and not going in for all those rebounds they were.
All right, that second free throw is good. And Van Worden with the ball for the Northmen. Brings it up on the right-hand side. Score 18-11. Inside to Ants. Ooh, contact there with the defender. And they waved the shot off, I think.
Yeah, they waved the shot off. It was an offensive
foul on Ants. Right?
Yes.
Okay. Check out the expert here now, you know. But that's great. And now Gaylord with the ball with only 42 seconds remaining, trailing by 7, 18-11. Northman back on defense as Gaylord brings the ball across the timeline over to the right-hand side to Polena. She gets down to the baseline, nothing there, so she passes it back out.
Oh.
Across to a wide-open Simmons, but I guess she was surprised nobody was on her and couldn't make the shot. Down the right-hand side for the Northmen, it's Ants back out on top and over to Fraser on the left-hand side. Fraser is being closely guarded, but dribbles the ball outside. Gets tied up out there, shoots it in, and there's 9 seconds remaining. Shot from the outside. Oh, my goodness.
Gosh. Liz Fraser has just made a shot 3 feet from the three-point line with 3 seconds left in the game.
And that's the end of the half. We'll talk about that shot when we come back, but right now it's halftime. Northmen leading 21-11, and we'll be right back with the UPS Store Petoskey Halftime Show right here on WJML News Talk Sports 1110 and 1210 and worldwide on WJML.com.
This year, the gift I'm getting is more time, and I'm getting it from that happy, jolly guy, Bob at the UPS store. Bob is a certified packing expert. He packs up my gifts, ships them out, and gets me in and out quickly. He even has extended holiday and weekend hours. Oh, he says that he gets it done with logistics. I think he has elves and a sleigh.
To find the location of the UPS store near you, visit theupsstore.com. Services, prices, and hours vary by location. See center for details.
Your Petoskey UPS store is your certified packing experts. Locally owned and operated and located in the Mitchell Street Plaza near Radio Shack. Mention that you heard this ad and you'll get a 10% discount on in-store custom packaging.
You don't need an invitation to drop into the Original Pancake House of Bay Harbor. Open every day at 7, the Original Pancake House features 42 unique breakfast entrees. They promise to have something for everyone's appetite. Try everything from their special oven-baked pancakes to the old-fashioned oatmeal, freshly squeezed juices, and farm-fresh eggs. Just some of the standards of quality you'll find at the Original Pancake House of downtown Bay Harbor. On the web at originalpancakehouse.com.
Welcome to the UPS Store Petoskey Halftime Show here at Gaylord. Happy to say that the Northmen are leading at halftime 21-11. And Caitlin, I know you're ready with the book and all that, and I do want to get the scoring for the first half. But before we get to that, we got a visitor here, Nelson Greenier, who did color with us on the broadcast last year. Happened to be at the game with his entire family, filling up the bleachers up there.
Yeah, just about.
Yeah, good seeing it. Nelson, what does the team look like to you? Is this the first game you've been to this year?
It is. It is the first game, you know, and it's a tough one being the first Big North Conference game, too. So it looked like both teams came out a little tight that first quarter, starting to open it up now. So,
yeah, well, what do you think of the Northmen play?
They're doing well. You know, they're having a little trouble, I think, with the zone right now, but Coach D's going to iron that out here at halftime, and they'll be moving that ball a little bit quicker around that zone, probably get a little bit more easier shots.
Okay, and on offense, looks like they were starting to solve that Gaylord defense about middle of the way through the first half.
Yeah, they're starting to look, you know, when they go inside, Gaylord's doubling team on the post, and the post is actually looking to kick it back out now. So they're doing a good job looking to back in-out game. It's doing real well.
Do you have any questions, Caitlin?
No, I don't have anything to say. Greener takes all the words out of my mouth.
Okay, well, yeah, well, you know, he's the coach. You know, he's used to having that last word. But that's all right. I think that the game was just going a little too fast for the Northmen for part of the game, and then not able to really settle down and concentrate on working their offense, trying to take the shots from the outside. And I think they had some opportunities to pass the ball around and make plays to get in on the offense, but they seem to be trying to take the easy way out most of the game.
Yeah, I agree with that. You know, they just need to calm down a little bit. Like you said, emotions are a little high being the first Big North game. You know, I know they played a tournament last week and split there. But the Big North is a good conference, and, you still get your adrenaline up a little bit. You still got to come down and start playing good basketball.
Right. Well, you and I watched a lot of games last year in the Big North Conference, and that first half of the season was a little painful to watch. I hate to say this in front of Caitlin here, but
She can take it.
She can. She's tough, you know, and she's already giving me a couple elbows in the ribs here, so, you know, I got to be a little careful.
She's like she's on the court, ain't it?
Yes, she is. Yes, she is. Yeah, I should have known that. I watched her play last year. But I think compared to the beginning of the season last year, this team's a little bit ahead of where they were then.
Yeah,
I agree. They're not having those kind of problems that they had the beginning of the year, but they do have a lot of things they have to work out. So you've been doing this coaching job for a while. They obviously need some talking to in the locker room. What's going on in there?
Yeah, well, you know, the first thing you got to do is try to settle them down a little bit. You know, tell them the first half didn't go really the way they wanted to. They did have a little run there towards the end, what they need to build on. And they need to come out and be a little more aggressive. I think defensively they can take some more chances with some double teams. And offensively, I think they still need to go in-out game, which they started getting used to. And that zone, I like to see them go high-low, which we ran quite a bit last year with Kelsey and Tompkins there, Megan.
Right, it looked like they were setting that up a little bit. They're getting some three-point shots, and then they have some people going to the inside, but they need to work the play of that.
It's got to be quicker. Yeah. You know, they're too slow getting to the spots. And Gaylord's doing a good job defensively, too. They know where the ball is going to go. They know the players. And, you can still get it, but you just have to be quicker to the spots than what they're getting there to.
All right, well, with all the criticisms and suggestions for improvement that we've been talking about, the Northerners still had 21-11, outscored Gaylord 14-5 in that second quarter. So they have no reason to panic now. I think it's a good opportunity for them to settle down and work on some of those things you were talking about.
Absolutely, and Coach D's doing that right now.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for coming down here, and hopefully we'll see you down the road in some of these other games. Thanks a lot, and thanks for being with us, Nelson.
Thank you. Enjoy.
All right. Right now, we got to take a break. We will be back with more of the UPS Store Petoskey Halftime Show right here on WJML News Talk Sports 1110 and 1210 and worldwide on WJML.com.
This year, the gift I'm getting is more time, and I'm getting it from that happy, jolly guy, Bob at the UPS store. Bob is a certified packing expert. He packs up my gifts, ships them out, and gets me in and out quickly. He even has extended holiday and weekend hours. Oh, he says that he gets it done with logistics. I think he has elves and a sleigh.
To find the location of the UPS store near you, visit theupsstore.com. Services, prices, and hours vary by location. See center for details.
Your Petoskey UPS store is your certified packing experts. Locally owned and operated and located in the Mitchell Street Plaza near Radio Shack. Mention that you heard this ad and you'll get a 10% discount on in-store custom packaging.
The Treetops KISS Principle. Keep it simple, skier. And that's what describes our season ski passes at Treetops, Michigan's most spectacular resort. Huge savings on family and multiple memberships. Just $155 per person for a triple. Okay, keep it simple. Go to treetops.com, Winter Adventures, and find a ski pass that is right for you, your group, your family, your student. Or 888-TREETOPS for more information. Safe, family-friendly Treetops. It's quite simply the best.
We are back with the UPS Store Petoskey Halftime Show. Score at halftime 21-11 with the Northland with quite a lead. And as we get ready for the second half with at least the Gaylord team back out on the floor, it seemed to me they're the ones who need a little more of a talking to, but the Northman's still in the locker room. I think the coach is taking the opportunity to do a little coaching at this point.
Yes, Caitlin. Definitely tries fixing the things that we saw in the first half that we need to be fixing. We saw in the second quarter that we start going inside out and how effective that was going for us. Hopefully we get some high-low action, like Coach Greener said, with Megan and Kelsey.
All right, well, Gaylord haven't gotten a lot of points so far, but they did score them. Where did they come from?
We have Chelsea Fox, and she had 2 points. Madison Hamilla is the one that's really been putting them up on the board, and she has 6 points. And then we have Alex Simmons, who has 3 points. So it's those three that are really dominating the court and looking in the inside.
All right. Is there anybody in foul trouble over on the Blue Devil side?
No, we don't have anyone in foul trouble. We have Paulina with one, Hines with one, and Ryder with one.
All right, now how about on the other side of the scorebook? There should be a little more, few more marks
just
over there.
Just a few more. We have Tompkins and Singer that both have two, so you know they're pretty good for the second half. They just got to watch it a little bit, and then we have Abby Blanchard and Kelsey with one.
All right, and how about the scoring?
The scoring, we have Tompkins with two, Liz Frazier with six, Kelsey Ants with seven, Alyssa Van Warden with four, and Abby Blanchard with one. So
okay, out of all those numbers, I think the one that's most indicative of the way that first half went was that Tompkins only has 2 points.
Yes.
You know, she's the person who's usually getting inside and scoring all those points, and she's been a team high scorer for the last two games.
Gaylord's doing right now a good job blocking her and not letting her, putting two people down there, so hopefully we can get some more points from her.
Okay. All right. Well, go ahead. I'm sorry.
That was all I had to say.
Jason's just making semaphore signals over there. You don't have to stop talking every time does that. So he did want to remind me that we're getting close to the beginning of the second half. So do want to say right now that wraps up the UPS Store Petoskey Halftime Show. And right now we're getting ready to start play here in half number two with the Northmen ahead 21-11. And about ready to go as the Northmen start the ball at half court, throwing it into Alyssa Van Warden, and she brings it across the timeline. And we are underway in the second half. Over to the right-hand side to Frazier. And we didn't talk about that play that had happened right at the end of that first half. We'll have to do that as soon as we have a moment here. There's a shot from Kelsey Ants from the corner for three. Good way to start off the second half. We want to see some action inside, but it's nice to see the three from the outside. Blue Devils out on top here. Trying to find some kind of an opening. It is Simmons with the ball at the top of the key. She gives it up to Polina. Now at the top of the key. They can't get the ball inside, and it's knocked out by Tompkins, picked up by the Northmen. That's Van Warden getting it into the forecourt, and now down to the right-hand corner to Frazier. Back to Frazier, Ants in the middle. Van Warden out on top for a three from the top of the key. She misses off the rim, and rebound goes to the Blue Devils. Over on the right-hand side, back out on the top of the key. Still no penetration, really, to speak of by the Blue Devils as they try to go around the right side, don't get anywhere, and try again, bringing it back out on top. Passing across the top, and Megan Tompkins steps in the way of that pass and bats it away from the receiver. Northland with the ball coming down the field. Ants driving towards the rim, puts it up and misses, rebounded by Megan Tompkins. So some outside points and some inside points now for the Northmen. And they call timeout. Let's go back over the end of that first half.
The first half of Liz Frazier?
Yeah.
Well, it was great that she got the ball at the top of the key and noticed the time situation, which is a great aspect that she can figure that out, how much time's on the clock. You know, took like three dribbles just to get around her player and put up a decent shot that happened to go in, which was 4 feet behind the three-point arc.
Yeah, I thought actually the Gaylord crowd was counting down about 10 seconds ahead of the real time. And I think she heard that and thought she had a little less time than she really had. And as she did a turnaround shot, and she kind of half turned around, and she thought that the time was running out. She had to get the shot off right away. So it was a little uncoordinated looking shot, you know, kind of with one arm out there. But she put it up and it worked, you know.
That's definitely probably going to be the play of the game. That's what we always did at the end of going into the next practice. We'd have the play of the game. So.
Yep. Well, and you want to go into the locker room with something good on your mind, and that definitely was it. Okay, well, we're in second half now, so let's talk about what's going on now. The play is about to start with the Blue Devils bringing the ball in under the basket. And the backcourt get it out to the timeline and all the way down to the baseline as they try to pass inside. That one, I think, was off Megan Tompkins' leg, but it bounced out anyway, and out of bounds to the Blue Devils. Down there in that leg foot area.
Yeah.
You know, all right, so now they try to curl into the inside. They get to the edge of the lane, and that's good enough to put the ball up. And 2 points for
Alex Simmons.
Blue Devils. That was Simmons. That's the last time. The person I missed last time was Simmons, I think, too. Anyway, they get the ball back on a rebound, in deep again. And this time a layup. That was nice positioning by Stephanie Buttrick and got down the field ahead of the court ahead of the Northmen, got the ball right on the side of the lane, took it in for the layup. Contact as Fraser tries to bring the ball up court. And who was it?
That was on Paulina.
Yeah, Paulina stepped in front of her. And yes. There was contact and foul called on Paulina. It was her second of the game. And not a shooting situation, so Northland get the ball out at midcourt. Comes into Ants in the the toss-up circle there in the middle of the court. Into Tompkins at the top of the key. Tompkins back to Ants over on the right-hand side. Looking around underneath. To Lewis, pops it up, rebounded by Tompkins, puts a layup underneath, but she hits the bottom of the rim, and the rebound comes down, and now calling a timeout on Petoskey. Good timeout because play was a little screwed up underneath the basket, and Coach D jumping in there to give him a chance to straighten it out.
That he is doing that on the last play. We got to really make sure we're getting back and meeting our passes because, you know, a crappy pass is going to lead to a steal, which led to the last 2 points they've just got.
Right. We want to make those passes inside, but we want to make good passes.
Yes.
That actually go to the people they're supposed to go to.
Go to the people they're supposed to go. Right. And
yeah, and that means moving when you're passing, moving when you're catching the ball. It's not just a question of accuracy. It's a question of, you know, continue to play and getting into position. All right, Northland with the ball underneath the basket back there. It is Lewis bringing the ball in. And she's having trouble throwing it. She better get it in quickly. She does to Yeah, that is Kelsey in the corner. Kelsey drives under the basket, puts up a hook, misses it. Tompkins brings it out to the top of the key. She's tied up by a Gaylord player. And down on the floor, kind of down there in the position that we used to see you in a lot. but tied up, and the ball goes to the Blue Devils. Yeah, you and Ants spent a lot of time down there.
Got a lot of bruises.
And yep. All right, back out on top now, and over to the right, into the corner there for the Blue Devils. They get the ball into the side of the lane. No further as they run into Megan Tompkins. Bring it out on top. That's playing out on top. Drive down the lane on the left-hand side. Shot misses, and rebound picked up off the floor by the Northland, but batted away. And now that's Ants. Oh, nope. Bennett Van Worden, who goes in there and scraps under the basket and picks it up. She's got the ball now down the middle of the lane. Stops, gives it to Ants, who drives the lane. Contact underneath. And I guess they're going to call it on Kelsey.
That's her second offensive fouls. That's the only way she's getting fouls tonight is on her offense. So.
Well, that's much. If she's going to have fouls, that's a much better way to get it from being aggressive. You know, you don't want her fouling.
She's not
offense.
Pushed using her arm. It's just the other people are setting themselves up.
Right.
Good.
She's not fouling way away from the basket or trying to bat a ball away after she missed the play. You know, like we saw in some of those times in the first game. So good to see that aggressiveness and the Blue Devils with the ball out on the top of the key now. Northman leading 26-15, 4:37 remaining in quarter number three. On the floor, tying it up under the basket, and ball goes to the Northman on the fickle finger. All right, that is Fraser with the ball now. So it comes inbounds to the Northman. She gets it up across the timeline. And looking left and right, finds Lewis over on the right-hand side in the middle to Tompkins, turns and guns, and puts it in off the backboard for the Northman. 4:20 remaining now, Northman leading 28-15. Gaylord ball, and almost goes out of bounds right in front of the score table, but they keep it in, down inside the baseline, and back out for a three-point shot from the side. That was Kuhn. And three-point shot was good. 28-18 now. Northman up by 10 with 3:58 remaining. Ben Worden now across midcourt. And she does a great job of bringing the ball up the court. And back now to Stinger, who's back in the game, over on the right-hand side of Lewis. Lewis underneath to Tompkins. She turns from the side of the lane, puts it up. Rebound down off the side of the rim, and another scramble for the ball and another tie-up. As you said earlier, these two teams scrapping for the ball.
This is a very scrappy team, and for Gaylord, this is like a huge game to beat Petoskey. You know, for us, it's just a conference game, but for Gaylord, this is like the World Series.
Well, right now, they're a little behind by about 10 points in the World Series. So still well within range. Ball goes out of bounds. And it is off the Northman. I think that was Megan Tompkins who hit the ball out. now standing out of bounds, ready to throw the ball in is Simmons. She gets it in way to the top of the key, but Van Worden knocks the ball away from the guard there, Hamilla, but she gets the ball back. Now Van Worden takes it away again. This time she's got it, and takes the ball up across the timeline. She turns, dishes it over to the corner to Lewis, back out on top. Now underneath to Tompkins, wide open down there. She turns around to put it up, misses, and as she gets the rebound, she falls backwards over a defender. She got up quickly, so it looks like she's okay, but the foul called on the Blue Devils. It's going to be called against Simmons. That's her first foul of the game, and non-shooting fouls in North and get it out of bounds. Megan looks to be fine as she gets the inbounds pass back out to Van Worden at the top of the key. It's wide of the rim and out of bounds, so that's going to the Blue Devils.
What great defense Alyssa had on that last play, stealing that ball. She was going to get called for five seconds, so she tried getting it off of Alyssa's leg to go out of bounds, but Alyssa had that great focus right there to just strip the ball from her and go down.
And I don't know whether she's doing such a great job of bringing the ball up the court or whether they don't apply the press when she's got it, but she's doing a great job of getting the ball out of her zone.
Yeah, she is definitely doing a lot better job at that.
Okay, Gaylord goes in for the layup, but they run into three Northmen as they come into the lane. Now it's out on top to Van Worden as she goes down the lane, gets most of the way down, puts it up, runs into a lot of defenders there. No call, but the shot is good, and the Northmen lead 38-18 now with 2:18 remaining in the third quarter. Down to the baseline for the Blue Devils. That's Hamilla who puts a shot in there from the corner. That's a three-pointer for her. And Northmen back with the ball with a 10-point lead, 30-20. At Van Worden again getting the ball across the timeline, easily into the Gaylord side. Down inside to Tompkins, back out on top, a three-point shot by Weaver, and goes out of bounds off the Northman.
We got a foul on on Liz Frazier. She had a little bit of a push there that they called.
Okay, that's Liz's second foul. Not too bad right near the end of the third quarter, so with a minute and 49 seconds remaining, Gaylord brings the ball in. They are trailing by 10 as they bring the ball across midcourt. Over to the right-hand side there is Hamilla. Gets it inside. One of the nice inside moves they had in this game so far. They had Buttrick with it, but you can't get the shot up. And ball is now out of bounds to Gaylord as they bring the ball in again. Over to the left-hand side, give Buttrick another chance. She gets it back out on top to Hintz. And foul, offensive foul on Gaylord.
Stephanie Buttrick's her second.
So now bringing the ball in from the baseline is Skolten. And couldn't get it in time.
That's when we really need to have those people that are at the free throw line waiting to flash up.
Yeah, especially when you've got a relatively short person scolding at 5'5", trying to get the ball in bounds. Anyway, we've got Buttrick out on top on the right, and now on the right-hand side. Her pass gets in the middle, but as they try to pass it back out, it goes out of bounds off the hands of Hamilla and turned over now to the Northman. And Skolten's going to try to bring the ball in again, this time from the corner. Gets it into Ants this time, and Ants brings it up the floor. She's looking over to the left-hand side for Fraser, and now finally passes it to her as they get it into the forecourt. Fraser brings it back out to the top, and back down to Stinger on the left-hand side. Stinger fakes going up with it, but passes it to Ants in the middle. She gets all alone in the middle of the lane. Nice flash there, nice pass to her by Stinger.
They had some nice screens going around. They were
as they bring the ball back out to midcourt, it's batted away by Fraser. Sorry to interrupt things will get interesting in the middle of the court. Back down on underneath now for the Blue Devils. They put up the shot inside, rebounded by both Ants and Tompkins. Tied up, though, as not between Ants and Tompkins, but as one of the Gaylord players gets in there and gets their hands on the ball. This time the fingers point to the Northman, so Skolten bringing it out on the baseline again and see if she does a little better, has a little better luck than she did last time. And she this time she gets help from Ants, who breaks free, and they pass the ball to Ants. Ants getting working against a double team, but very casually, no problem, passes it up to Lewis, and they easily have the ball in the forecourt. Lewis on the right-hand side packs it back on top to Larson. Underneath, the pass goes wild as they try to get the ball into Stinger underneath. Stinger ready to bring the ball in, though, from the baseline. Brings it into Ants, and Ants dribbles it back out on top. There's 14 seconds remaining now in the third quarter. Northman 32-20. Ants keeps the ball. Now she drives in, passes it back out on top to Lewis. Over on the left-hand side in the corner, back out on top to Lewis. Somebody's got to shoot, and they're going up with it. She's not in. That had to be Stinger. Maybe.
It was Amanda, and Hannah went up with the last two shots, but just hit the rim.
All right, so this gets us to the end of the third quarter, Northman leading 32-20, and we'll be back for the final stands in just a minute on WJML News Talk Sports 1110 and 1210 and worldwide on WJML.com.
This year, the gift I'm getting is more time, and I'm getting it from that happy, jolly guy, Bob at the UPS store. Bob is a certified packing expert. He packs up my gifts, ships them out, and gets me in and out quickly. He even has extended holiday and weekend hours. Oh, he says that he gets it done with logistics. I think he has elves and a sleigh.
To find the location of the UPS store near you, visit theupsstore.com. Services, prices, and hours vary by location. See center for details.
Your Petoskey UPS store is your certified packing experts. Locally owned and operated and located in the Mitchell Street Plaza near Radio Shack. Mention that you heard this ad and you'll get a 10% discount on in-store custom packaging.
We are back as it's time for the fourth quarter here. Northland stretching it out just a little bit in the third quarter, outscoring Gaylord by 2 points, 11-9, mm-hmm. as we're underway now in the fourth quarter. Gaylord with the ball, get back out on top, and looking around over to the left-hand side there to Hintz. Hintz passes it to an open Polano. Shot goes up, takes a three from the outside and misses. Ants with the ball now for the Northman, brings it up to Van Worden on the left-hand side. Ooh. As she goes in, the key for the shot, there's contact underneath.
With Paulina.
And they call the foul on Polina, blocking foul. And going to the line now, Van Worden with the Northman leading 32-20 just into play in the fourth quarter. Van Worden at the line.
It's really crucial that, you know, Alyssa can hit these free throws to just further up their lead. And right now it's all about the last, who has the most stamina right now.
And watching the players, what do you think the answer to that is?
I don't know. It's getting pretty close. Right, it looks like we are pulling through and we have better looks underneath the basket, but Gaylord's looking pretty, you know, they're not ready to give up yet.
Well, we'll see as Van Worden makes both of those free throws and leads now 34-20, the Northman. Out on top is Buttrick, who's really playing a very aggressive game, playing very hard, doing a really good job, but this time ball, I guess, knocked out of her hand, trying to see if they called anything on that, but it's going to be Northman ball, and pass comes into Van Worden.
Yep.
Brings it up across the midcourt line. She was able to keep driving down into the lane, but the ball knocked out of her hand, and as they look around trying to figure out what to do, it's called on Buttrick.
And it's her third now.
Yep. And Northman gets the ball out of bounds. That is Lewis. Lewis passes it into Ants over on the near side. That was a three. She misses. About two Northmen inside for the rebound. It was Tompkins and Lewis, but it was tied up, and Gaylord gets the ball on the arrow. Bringing the ball up the court now, Polina gets across the timeline over the left-hand side to Buttrick. Buttrick backs up with it across, and it's intercepted in the middle by Ants as they try to pass it inside. Ants down the court, off the front of the rim. That may be a little sign of fatigue there, too. You know,
well, I think Ants is afraid of be calling for another offensive foul, so that's the reason why she's not going to go to the court, because Gaylord's pretty good at taking those charges.
Yeah, she pulled up a little short in that lane, but the shot was short, too, hitting the front of the rim. Sometimes that's a fatigue sign, but it might be exactly what you said. She's kind of holding back.
It could be both.
Yeah. I'll defer to your wisdom on that one. All right, over here on the right-hand side now for the Blue Devils. Back out on top now, and down in the corner to Simmons. Simmons is double-teamed there by Anson. Van Worden. Shot goes up, and Van Worden bats it down. And then underneath, Ants bats down the next shot, but the whistle blew before that. And it's a call.
Also number 30.
On Alyssa, her second foul.
Grabbing the arm. And 34-20 with 6:23 remaining in the ballgame as Gaylord brings the ball in from the baseline out on top, back over to the right-hand side. That Simmons tries to get the ball in the middle, gets it knocked out of her hand, and now she picks it up outside and starts setting up again, closely guarded by Kelsey Ants. Back across the top over there to Polina. Driving in, stops as she's cut off, brings it back out. Shot goes up, it's blocked by Ants. Goes to Tompkins, and the Northmen keep the Blue Devils out of the lane again with some good aggressive defense and some nice shot blocking. Northmen now with the ball. That's Van Worden passing it into Blanchard at the top of the key over the left-hand side of Lewis, down in the corner to Ants. She looks around, doesn't see anything she likes, and passes it back out to Van Worden, who finds Tompkins nicely underneath the basket. Megan's always open when she's standing under there. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like one of those wide receivers in football who's a foot taller.
Just got to give her that nice lead pass, and she can make it happen.
Get the ball up higher than anybody else could get it. And as Gaylord brings the ball up the court, the whistle blows, and this is going to be a Northmen foul, it looks like. And coming into the game for the Northmen is Liz Fraser. Foul was called on Katie Lewis, her first. And it's a non-shooting foul ball brought in from the outside by the Blue Devils. Northmen leading 36-20. And the ball over in the bounds all over the right-hand side, back out on top of the key to Simmons. As she turns around, Ants tries to knock it out of her hand, but she gets a little bit of arm, and the foul's called on Kelsey. That's her third of the game. Non-shooting foul again, so it's going to be out of bounds, and it's Lauren Hint standing right in front of the scorer's table, passes the ball into Polina. Polina dribbles behind her back, passes it over to the side there now, over to the right-hand side. As Simmons tries to get the ball in, runs into Ants, backs up, and finds Buttrick. And then puts the ball up. It's rebounded by Ants. Again, unable to penetrate really into the zone. Northman bring the ball up the court. It's outside to Fraser. Fraser brings the ball down, looks around Van Worden on the right-hand side. And the whistle blows as I believe Hintz had her arm on Van Worden.
It's on Megan Tompkins. She got a little bit of a push. Right now we really want to watch our fouls. We're going to be in 1-1 soon.
Yeah, Northman with 17 fouls, and Gaylord with only 5. Gaylord with the ball now, Northman leading 36-20. Ball on the right-hand side to Polina. Polina tries to drive into the middle. She's blocked by Fraser, turns around, and ball gets away and gets to Van Worden. Northman clogging up the middle again and stopping Gaylord from getting anything inside. Van Worden out on top, dribbles down the lane. Finds Buttrick underneath. She puts it up. Blanchard underneath. Puts it up. And rebound comes down to Gaylord. Over on the right-hand side. Cross to the left now. Put up. It's a three by Polina. And tightens things up a little bit. It's 36-23 now with 4 minutes remaining in the game. Van Worden with the ball in the backcourt against one defender. And she brings it out with not much problem across the timeline looking around. Fraser out there with her, but she passes underneath to Ants. Ants turns around quickly, puts it up off the rim, rebounded by the Blue Devils, but Ants ties it up right away, and ball going to the Northmen.
We really want to make sure we're getting down low and getting all the rebounds we can. You can tell that Gaylord is not giving up right now. They're going to fight until the time goes out. So right now we are kind of being lazy with our feet. We're not moving our feet, and we're really reaching in, and we're going to get called for those fouls. So we got to watch that right now.
Although Ants did a really good job of getting in a position on that play. And now as the pass comes in, Fraser is open underneath too, but she shoots a hook shot that misses. Down at the other end of the court, their layup by Hamilla misses, and Northman with the ball. Coming quickly up the court is Lewis, and out on top now to Larson over the right-hand side. Shot goes up. Rebound inside by Ants, and she puts it right back up and in. Northman now up 38-23 with 3:12 remaining in the game. Cross-court pass for the Blue Devils. They try to pass towards the inside, but it's Fox is blocked by Lewis, and Tompkins was standing right there, but Fox did the job, and she fouled, I believe it was her. Oh, no, they called the foul on Tompkins.
They called the foul on Tompkins. She has four right now, so she really has to be careful. There's 3 minutes left in the game, and that's still a lot of time. So,
shooting the free throw is Chelsea Fox. She misses, and Northman now ahead by 15, 38-23 with 3 minutes and 5 seconds remaining. Outcome, not too much in doubt, but there's a lot of play remaining and got a lot to see what happens. Ball out on top, and this one misses as well on the free throw. Rebounded by Kelsey Ants, and she starts the ball up court, gets across the timeline, goes down the left-hand side, passes across to Fraser out on top of the key. Fraser looking inside, passes to Van Worden on the left-hand side, back out to Stinger on top, Weaver on top. And now it's Liz Fraser who brings it all the way around, circle down to the left-hand side, goes to the baseline, puts it up, misses. Ants takes it to the hole, but it's knocked out of her hands. I believe a foul called on Gaylord as Kelsey does a great job of going to the hole and drawing that foul.
The foul was called on Chelsea Fox.
And she's getting the ball out of bounds. I guess they call it. Well, it was a rebound, I guess, really, not a shooting foul. So now Van Worden with the ball in the middle, passes it over to the right-hand side. There's Larson taking that shot, and I think that was a three. Don't know. Well, it's 40 points, so.
That was a very nice shot on Larson, getting herself that nice open space.
Foul now called on Fraser. That's her third. And the Northman, I think, feeling that things are getting a little ragged here. You know what? You want to play all the way out to the end of the game with the...
You know, they have 2 minutes and 23 seconds left. They just need to finish it out. I know they're really tired. It's the pre-game or preseason, and you never know how much good conditioning you can do during preseason. So they just need to finish out this game strong. Yes, we're winning by a little less than 20 points, but just finish.
Yep. Go out looking good. And not only that, we got another game coming up. So we want to play this one the right way and learn the lessons that we can from it. And that's what the coach is doing right now, teaching and getting everybody organized and ready to come back out on the floor in a more organized way. A nice job in general. It's kind of like the way that I felt about the Marquette game, you know? Mm-hmm. They're doing a lot of the right things, but they're not doing them all the time.
And if you look at it, this is preseason. If they're doing this nice of a job already, you only have to go up from when the end of the tournament comes.
Right. I don't think there's a lot of skills that they have to hone. It's the concentration and the playing with those skills all the time.
Yes, and it's just finishing the game. Do not stop for a quarter. Do not stop for a play. Just keep playing the whole thing.
Pulling at the free throw line. She makes her first one, and she's got another shot coming. That makes it 40-24 with 2:23 remaining in the ballgame. And Pulling lines up for a second one. That one goes in. And Northman take the ball out under the basket. It is Van Worden bringing it up on the right hand side. She hesitates for a second and then drives right past Chelsea Fox. Passes it to Ants. And Ants back out to Van Worden as Ants got double team. Van Worden finds the Weaver over on the right hand side. Passes it across left to Fraser. Fraser dribbling around on the top and gives it back to Van Worden. Van Worden inside to Fraser on the right, and she dribbles across and into the lane, pops the ball back out to Weaver, and shot goes up and off the rim, rebounded by the Blue Devils. Blue Devils, as they bring the ball, start to bring the ball up the court, whistle blows, and I think it's a timeout on the Blue Devils.
I think right now the coach is taking a timeout to just pull out the players. I think he is now putting in the subs and just letting them play, giving everyone a break and telling the new subs what they want to do and what they're trying to execute on the court right now.
Right. It's also, we were talking about how it's the first conference game for the Northmen. It's also the first conference game for the Blue Devils, and he doesn't want to waste the last
minute
of play. He wants to get those players in there and have them play basketball.
You know, that's really great that coaches do that, letting everyone play and the opportunity. And I know that the starters on the Blue Devils team and on any team would be happy to get those players in when they can, because they are such great supporters to have those teammates on the bench. Yep.
And on the Northmen, we see in the huddle there, we see Megan Tompkins is standing up, Katie Lewis is standing up. You know, the people who are in are sitting down. Kelsey Ants was standing up. So we've got now on the floor, we've got Skulton and Will. Will hasn't been in the game yet, I don't think. Van Worden. We'll pick them up as we go along. Weaver. So a lot of people out there who haven't had
Jamie Larson.
A lot of people who haven't had a lot of play. They're on defense now as Gaylord shoots over the top of that defense and misses a three-pointer from the outside. Van Worden, one of the maybe the only starters still in the game right now. They like to leave one in there.
Yeah, you got to have one that, you know, can initiate, you know, tell people where they need to go if they forget.
Right.
It's kind of, you know, it kind of takes a minute or 30 seconds to warm up in a basketball game.
Right. Ball to Skulton, who's also been in the game before, so she's ready. Pass over to the right-hand side, back out to Skulton now. There's only a minute remaining. Northmen don't seem like they're in a big hurry to get the ball inside, but they're looking to set things up and make the play work. So they're not just passing back and forth outside. Skulton gets her first three-pointer. You know, that's her reputation. She came out of the team from JV last year with that being her big shot. We didn't see much of it last year, but now she gets into the game more. We should see some more of that. Gaylord with the ball, and their throw to the middle goes out of bounds. Northern leading 43-25 with 38.7 seconds remaining in the ball game, and Northern ready to bring the ball out.
We have Alyssa coming out, and Asia Adam Craig, or did I say that right?
Abram Craig. And I don't think she's been in yet. So that's good. Northman with the ball now. Natalie Weaver there driving across the middle. Her pass knocked away. But it's Northman ball, I believe. And Natalie Weaver to bring the ball in for the Northman. She passes it into Skulton. And Skulton looking for something to do with it there with 22 seconds remaining. Down to the left-hand side to Larson. As Larson brings it across the middle. Larson across the other side to Skulton. And Skulton to Weaver in the middle. Over here on the left-hand side, that was Will, and her shot goes just off the rim. And these players, even though they're not starters, are following the example of starters by scrambling for the ball on the floor. On the jump, it goes to the Blue Devils, and they bring the ball across half court. A game-ending shot from half court misses, and so we come to the end of the game with the score right, so the final score, Northman winning 43-25, and we'll be back to wrap the game up in just a minute right here on WJML News Talk Sports 1110 and 1210 and worldwide on WJML.com.
This year, the gift I'm getting is more time, and I'm getting it from that happy, jolly guy, Bob at the UPS store. Bob is a certified packing expert. He packs up my gifts, ships them out, and gets me in and out quickly. He even has extended holiday and weekend hours. Oh, he says that he gets it done with logistics. I think he has elves and a sleigh.
To find the location of the UPS store near you, visit theupsstore.com. Services, prices, and hours vary by location. See center for details.
Your Petoskey UPS store is your certified packing experts. Locally owned and operated and located in the Mitchell Street Plaza near Radio Shack. Mention that you heard this ad and you'll get a 10% discount on in-store custom packaging.
This holiday season, give the gift that gives to others. Shop from home, save on gas, avoid the crowds, and most importantly, support your local charitable organizations to serve others who need help right here in Northern Michigan. It's the WJML Alternative Gift Mall, online at northernmichiganmall.com, and click on Alternative Gifts. You can donate to local organizations in someone's honor and receive gift cards describing each gift. Choose from charities such as the Manna Food Project, the Community Free Clinic, the Harbor Springs Food Pantry, Great Start Preschool, the Northwest Michigan Community Action Agency, the Nehemiah Project, Women's Resource Center, and Habitat for Humanity. 100% of all donations go directly to the organizations that you choose. Celebrate the spirit of the season. Support your community with gifts from the WJML Alternative Gift Mall, online at northernmichiganmall.com.
Bob, what are you doing out there with that rifle and dynamite?
I hated that old credit card machine so much that after Silver Dollar Business Solutions came by, this'll be fun.
No, that's dangerous.
Oh, we don't need that old thing anymore. Silver Dollar Business Solutions got me a better system and lowered my rates. My customers are happy with quicker checkout, and we're keeping more of our hard-earned revenue.
Well, it sounds like you've really thought through the business part, but that pile of dynamite has me worried.
Oh, it'll be great.
If you own or manage a business and hate your credit card processor, Silver Dollar Business Solutions can help. Whether you need to lower your costs on your current equipment or replace your processing system, Silver Dollar Business Solutions is here for you. You will be so happy you'll want to celebrate, but please don't do anything dangerous.
I guess the dynamite wasn't such a good idea.
2-3-1-7-5-8-2-8-5-1 Silver Dollar brings value to you.
Back in Gaylord here as the Northmen win their first game of the Big North Conference season, defeating the Gaylord Blue Devils by a score of 43-25. I do want to tell you about the video of this game. You know that we've recently very much upgraded what we're doing on the videos, and we are recording this much improved DVD quality video version of our broadcast of every Petoskey Northman basketball game. These video replays will be available on demand on WJML.com for the rest of the season. The first one, the game against Marquette, is already up there, and you can go see it by going to WJML.com and clicking on the link, which is real obvious on there. You won't have any trouble finding it. You do know that the rules of the Michigan High School Athletic Association prohibit us from showing you the video live during the game, which is what we'd really like to do, but we can't. So this game will probably be up there tomorrow or next day pretty soon. We'd like to get them up the day after the game. So just go to WJML.com, follow the link, and watch the replay. Caitlin, pretty nice game for the Northmen. They led it really all the way. They won every quarter. They have some things they have to work out, but in general, playing a pretty solid game tonight.
They did play a pretty great game tonight. It's only the third game of the season, so for what they're doing right now is great. They just have to, you know, watch out. Next time they'll have Mackenzie Edwards the next time they play Gaylord. So, you know, what adjustments are they going to make? At first it was pretty close, and to have that close of a game and then have their best player back on the court is going to be to see what we're really made of.
Yeah, well, they won by, what is that? I don't know. Whatever it is, do the subtraction. But it's less than 20. And with Mackenzie Edwards, that might be a 20-point difference.
Yes.
Right there. So, but there were other people out on the court. They did a really pretty good job. And while we're talking about that, when we take a look at it, why don't you let us know who got those 25 points for the Gaylord Blue Devils?
Chelsea Fox, she had 2. Madison Hamilla had 7. Alex Simmons had 8. Sarah Paulina had 5. And Stephanie Buttrix had 2.
All right, so pretty well spread out. Hamilla and Simmons get most of those points.
Yes.
And, you know, two of the Well, Hamill is a junior, Madison Hamill. So that's good. But she's a junior. She's got a lot of experience playing on this team. Now, over on the other side, we've got the Petoskey North. And how did they get their victorious 43 points?
Hannah Skolton had 3. Tompkins had 8. Frazier had 6. Ants had 14. Larson had 2. Weaver had 2. Alyssa Van Warden had 7. And Abby Blanchard had 1.
Actually, yep, there you go. Yeah, she had that one free throw. Right? Right, and Skolton got her first three of the year, right? And so we hope that breaks the spell for her, and that we'll be seeing a lot more of those coming out of her hands. Northman shooting that three a fair amount, especially early in the game when they weren't getting inside. They seemed, as the game went on, to develop that a little bit better, but they had some work to do during practice.
Yes, just a little bit. You know, they really did well getting that open shot outside. It's just coming out from the get-go of trying to get it on the outside, being a threat in the inside and the outside, which is really going to mess up teams' defense.
And now that they've gotten the first conference game out of the way, their next game is a non-conference game as they go up to the tip of the mitt there and play Sheboygan on next Monday. And Sheboygan, usually, I don't know what they're like this year, but usually not a real tough team, a good opportunity for them to work on their moves, their positioning, mm-hmm. getting organized, and bring some of that back to conference play.
I know Sheboygan, they had a senior Hancock that was really good, and she's gone. So I think there's a few players they have to watch out for, but like you said, it's, you know, not the best competition. It's a game they can take advantage of really working and trying some new things to see if they want to work it.
And those kind of games at this point of the season, you need to concentrate on and need to get full advantage out of playing a team that maybe you can be a little more patient and set up your offense and your defense mm-hmm. a little bit better. But they were pretty awesome on defense tonight. We were talking a lot about the offensive issues they were having, but on defense, as they're always going to be, they're very mm-hmm. tough inside. Gaylord had a very difficult time getting anything done inside, and I think that's the biggest problem their offense had for the whole game was getting inside against the Northman.
And they had some excellent ball pressure by Liz Frazier and Alyssa Van Warden. You know, without, you can't make an easy pass, it just affects the whole offense, and they couldn't get inside. They weren't really getting good looks on the outside. Yes, they had a few threes, but overall it was very good defense by those two.
Yep, couldn't pass over the lane, and they certainly couldn't pass through the lane. And it's not just the passing. They couldn't really drive the lane either.
No.
I mean, somebody started to do that. There were three people standing in mm-hmm. front of them. So that part of the game, you know, really seems to be working out pretty well. Once they get done with Sheboygan, we have a little trip to take for Friday, December 14th. We're going to go to Cadillac and get the second Big North Conference game of the year in. And it should be exciting as we start moving in the Big North Conference, and especially thinking back to last year, having a chance now to go 2-0 in the conference if we can win that. And that sure, I would think that takes a lot of pressure off the last half of the season. You've always got pressure in the last half of the season because that's when you're trying to get to the championship
yeah.
and get ready for the playoffs and all that. But when you go into the last half of the season, what was it, 0-8 or something like that?
It was like 1-8.
1-8. Yeah, let's not make it any worse than it was. You don't have any cushion, and it's got to affect your confidence. And hopefully, you know, although it was right after that, you know, right after that first half that you guys really came alive and took care of it last year. And, well, I suppose if you had your choice, you wouldn't start the second half 1-8.
We knew we had it in us the whole year. Last year, we just had a hard time, you know, learning our new roles. You know, we lost Kirby Tam and Carly Searles and Bernadette LeBlanc. So trying to decipher our new roles, like we don't lost our ball handle and our main scorer
yep.
was difficult.
Since you brought up Kirby, have you had a chance to watch her on TV or go see her?
I saw her last year, and uh-huh. we all, you know, wore T-shirts and cheered her on, and it was amazing how well she was doing, and she was getting some playing time. She was kind of like the Hannah Skolton, you know, go in, get those threes, play solid defense, and then, you know, come out. But she was getting some good minutes down there at CMU.
Yeah, well, they were on TV last week or over the weekend or Sunday. I don't know when it was, but sometime real recently. And it was funny. It was on the Big Ten Network. And they were playing, I think it was Purdue or some Big Ten team, and they, you know, so the announcers were very Big Ten oriented, and I think they almost never said the name of any of the Central players.
Oh, wow.
But she was out there, you know, number 12 and playing away, and it was great to watch and see her out there. She's looking really good and doing a good job over there. But here, we're going to take a quick break. And we will be right back to wrap this thing up and get all you folks on the road and ready for going to Sheboygan. So we'll be right back on WJML News Talk Sports 1110 and 1210 and worldwide on WJML.com.
This year, the gift I'm getting is more time. And I'm getting it from that happy, jolly guy, Bob at the UPS store. Bob is a certified packing expert. He packs up my gifts, ships them out, and gets me in and out quickly. He even has extended holiday and weekend hours. Oh, he says that he gets it done with logistics. I think he has elves and a sleigh.
To find the location of the UPS store near you, visit theupsstore.com. Services, prices, and hours vary by location. See center for details.
Your Petoskey UPS store is your certified packing experts. Locally owned and operated and located in the Mitchell Street Plaza near Radio Shack. Mention that you heard this ad and you'll get a 10% discount on in-store custom packaging.
Parents, remember that big hit your kid took during the game? The kid probably doesn't. So after the game, watch out for signs that a concussion may have taken place. Signs and symptoms don't always show up right away, so learn what to look for. Get more information about concussions, including access to free online education courses, by visiting the MHSAA website and clicking on Education. A message from the Michigan High School Athletic Association, promoting the value and values of educational athletics.
You don't need an invitation to drop into the Original Pancake House of Bay Harbor. Open every day at 7, the Original Pancake House features 42 unique breakfast entrees. They promise to have something for everyone's appetite. Try everything from their special oven-baked pancakes to the old-fashioned oatmeal, freshly squeezed juices, and farm-fresh eggs. Just some of the standards of quality you'll find at the Original Pancake House of downtown Bay Harbor. On the web at originalpancakehouse.com.
The human body is more than 75% water, and this water needs to be replenished every day. Pure Waterworks Bottled Water Services delivers the highest quality water to your home or business. Whether it's softening, conditioning, or drinking water, Pure Waterworks can bring quality water directly to you. We make doing business with us a pleasure, and quality bottled water is just a phone call away. 1-800-248-PURE. That's 1-800-248-PURE. P-U-R-E.
Okay, here we are back in Gaylord. Petoskey North and winning tonight's game by a score of 43-25. Before we get out of here, we do want to continue with a tradition on these broadcasts. And now that tradition passes to Caitlin, who gets the honor of naming the Eye of the Tiger, the player, really the player of the game for tonight's game. So, Caitlin, take it away.
All the Northmen played really well tonight, but I think the Eye of the Tiger has to go to Liz Frazier. Her defense and ball pressure was really remarkable on how well she did and helped defense. She really stepped it up from the outside, shooting threes. That's not usually what she does. She's more of like a defensive threat, but stepping it up and scoring those threes, and I just have to give it to her.
Excellent. I agree with you completely. And, you know, doing what your team needs you to do in a particular game is one of the important parts of a good player. And sometimes it's all written out there in the roles that everybody knows everybody has. And sometimes it's taking a role that nobody else seems to take that somebody needs to have in that game. And I agree. An excellent player tonight's game. I want to thank you for joining the team. And,
well, you're welcome.
As far as I'm concerned, you did a great job. And we love having you on here. And hopefully you'll keep your promise. We didn't scare you away. We'll keep your promise and come back and be with us for the rest of the season. I'm certainly looking forward to it. We talked about that game at Sheboygan. Our next game is going down to Cadillac on Friday, December 14th, and we will bring that one to you for carry on with the rest of the season. For now, the Petoskey Northern victory tonight was brought to you by your local Petoskey UPS store. your certified packaging expert, located in the Mitchell Street Plaza near Radio Shack. Silver Dollar Business Solutions. Increase your business's bottom line with value-added electronic payment services. Northern Michigan Artist Market, with art in all media by over 90 local Northern Michigan artists from Traverse City to the top of the Upper Peninsula at 445 East Mitchell Street next to the Old Library in Petoskey's historic Gaslight District. And speaking of the Gaslight District, it's the open house this Friday in downtown Petoskey, so don't miss out on that. And, of course, special thanks to WJML Radio News Talk Sports 1110 and 1210 and worldwide on WJML.com. Tonight's final score, Petoskey Northmen take the victory 43-25 over the Gaylord Blue Devils. And we'll see you on Friday, December 14th on WJML News Talk Sports 1110, 1210, and worldwide on WJML.com.